This class we discuss about the difference between impedance and reactance diagram. Single line diagram SLD is converted into impedance or reactance diagram by showing equivalent circuit of each component of power system by the single phase equivalent circuit. There are 8 assumptions are used to draw the impedance diagram. 1. Under balanced load or fault conditions, no current flows through the transformer neutral and it is at same potential as the system neutral, therefore the transformer impedance is neglected. Number 2, the generator neutral impedance is neglected for the above reason. Number 3, transformer magnetizing current is very less compared to its full load current, therefore shunt admittance of the transformer is neglected. Number 4, the capacitance of the transmission lines are neglected. Number 5, the resistance of various components of power system is very low compared to its reactance, therefore the resistances are neglected. Number 6, all static loads are neglected. Number 7, induction motors are neglected for computing fault current. Current contribution during the fault vanish out very shortly after the induction motor is short circuited. Number 8, shunt branches in the equivalent circuit of the transformer are neglected. Load active power megawatt and reactive power mega volt ampere reactive are considered to be constant. This is highly used in the load flow studies. The magnitude of load current is considered as constant. Impedance diagram is very useful for load flow studies. Reactance diagram is very useful for short circuit studies. This is a single phase equivalent circuit of a 3-phase alternator, 3-phase synchronous motor, transformer, induction motor, transmission line pi-type, transmission line t-type, 3-winding transformer. For a generator, internal EMF E in series with the winding resistance and subtransient reactance. But in the case of transformer, winding resistance in series with the leakage reactance and the shunt impedance to account for magnetizing current. For a transmission line, total resistance and line reactance in series arm and capacitance to earth divided between its shunt arm. For a lagging type load, resistance in series with the reactance. This is a typical single line diagram of a power system. This power system consists of 4 generators, 2 transformers, 2 loads and 1 transmission line. Total number of components are 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the impedance diagram. This is generator 1, generator 2, load. This is 3, this is transformer 4, transmission line 5, transformer this is 6, the load is 7, generator this is generator 8, another generator 9. If we neglect all the resistances in the impedance diagram, we got a reactance diagram. This is the reactance diagram of this network. This is the basic difference between impedance and reactance diagram. Thanks for listening.